Hi, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be unboxing the Maker Crate. I'm really excited to get into this. I have several crafts I have not been doing because I haven't been feeling well, if you saw my pregnancy announcement video. And so I'm hoping to get to all these crafts pretty soon. So hopefully I will get to this one because I'm really, really excited to get back to doing some crafts. And so if you are new to my channel, I created this channel as a homeschooling resource to give you different unboxings, which is what we're doing today, to give you curriculum ideas, organizational ideas, and ways to invite Christ in your homeschool space. So if you're interested in those things, please hit that subscribe button and let's get into this crate. Okay, so this box is heavy this month because we're doing mini clay succulents. And whenever there's clay in these boxes, they're always pretty heavy. Says sculpt and mold polymer clay to craft a colorful miniature garden. We've used polymer clay before, but there's so many different types of clay. And I'm not super great with clay, and so I don't remember all the different types and kind of how they all work. But when you open it up, this is what it looks like. So it looks like maybe we have some molds in here, which will be helpful for me because, again, clay isn't my strong point when it comes to crafting. So, but this is an example kind of right here of what it can look like. I wonder if you put like magnets on the back, I'm not really sure. And then the instructions for this are found online. They're like video tutorials and stuff. So you can either scan it or there's a website right here. And in here I like to look because I am really good at copying other people's ideas. So they'll have some ideas in here and then usually they have like a little bit of history about it. So the first thing in here is a little silicone mold and with just the flowers in it. I don't know, it's really cool looking. So that'll be fun to try out. Oh yes, so there is some magnets in here. So it looks like you put the magnets on the back. And then clay tools, I wonder if these are similar to the other clay tools we have gotten in the past or if it's different. So there's a rolling pin that looks like that. This one has a little ball on one end and then kind of this silicone thing on the back, on the other end. I don't even know, let me see if I can get it closer. It looks kind of like that, but it's soft. And then we have this little guy. So we'll be able to use those. And then we have some little dots. I'm not sure if those are to help with our magnets or what. And then this is a mat. So it has a whole bunch of templates on it. So that's nice. Nice for people like me who this isn't their strong point. And so we have a whole bunch of examples right there. And then this is the board you can display it on, which seems actually really nice. So it looks like it should light up, but I don't think it does. So I think it's just a magnet board, which, you know, once you get done with these flowers, because again, this isn't really my aesthetic, but I still think it's fun to try, is, you know, making all these succulent flowers and displaying them. But this probably could be used just as a magnet board in general and just set it somewhere. And so I like how there's that option. It can be reusable. And then we have all of our clay back here. So there is a variety of colors. Some of them are bigger, some of them are smaller. And I think that's all that's in here. So this is going to be fun to try. I feel like this is a shorter craft in a way, you know, because like you have the drying time, or maybe, oh, these ones you bake. I'm like, I can't remember. I think the polymer, maybe you bake, but I couldn't remember. Anyway, so these ones, it looks like you're gonna bake them. And so it's a little bit of a shorter craft. Usually this is something I can just finish in a day, where some of the other crafts take a lot longer time. So I like how there's always kind of a mix and it's not the same thing over and over again. So I'm excited to try this out and to let you know how it goes. So I'm gonna get at it and I will see you when I'm done. finished doing the Maker Crate, at least one of them that I have, but this one will go up first, even though this one is July. I still have the June one, but this one is took less time. The other one takes more time and I got it late, all the things. So this one will come up first, but let me just show you what I did. First of all, it was slightly frustrating for me. I don't know, working with clay is not my favorite thing. I was still like glad to try it, but I'll tell you some of the things that were super frustrating for me. So here is my, what is it? Mini clay succulent garden. And so it has this cool little stand, which I do really love this stand because you can use it for other things. It even said that you could write without like a marker on it. And so you could, after you're done with the succulent thing, because this isn't really my vibe right here, you can use it to just write stuff on. So that, I just thought that would be cute. Or you can take this off and like hang it on the wall if you prefer that. So anyways, it comes with this mold right here. Sorry, I just whacked the table. It comes with this mold, which if I could just make them like this, then I would be totally happy. So this still takes a while because you have to make sure the clay is really pushed down there. So it still took me, I don't know, 30, 45 minutes to fill all of these because I wanted to make sure all the little nooks and crannies were filled. But here, this one, you know, you can see they look like soaps from here, you know, from this mold, they look like soaps. So we have all these different ones in here that came from the mold. And then I tried a few that were the sculpting ones. And when you watch the video, they make it look so easy. They just like go through it, shape them, you know, because you have this little mat. Sorry, that was loud. Let me grab it. So you have this mat that has some of the shapes on it. And you can see some of the clay that stained it. And so you're trying to make them similar in shape to this. I almost wish they had I could lay it on top of the clay and like cut out around it. Anyways, so it's kind of hard to like get them the right shape. And sometimes the clay gets really sticky. So anyways, it was a little bit of a struggle for me. Again, clay is not my strong point over here. But this, so these ones I made, let me hold them up closer so you can see them a little bit better. But I made this little guy. He reminds me of like a little sea coral type thing. And so this one was actually the easiest one because I just like rolled it into worms. And then the other ones were a little bit harder because you had to try to shape them into leaves. But this is one of them that I made. And then this is the other one. This one was slightly easier because I just did some rounded leaves and put them pointed at the end and then stuck them together. I tried to do another one. I think it was with these leaves, the silver star, and I was having a hard time. So I squished it back together and was like, forget it. We're not doing that. So I feel like these ones obviously look more realistic. They don't look like you have a little bar of soap right here, but they also are harder. And I think it took me at least an hour, probably more, just to make these three. And so you could make these for hours. Like you could take all day. So if you have that time, be my guest, do it all day. And I have plenty of clay left, right? There's tons here. So maybe we'll still experiment. Maybe if I just want to do something with my hands while watching a show one night, I'll play with this some more, let my kids play with it. The darker colors do stain your hands. I probably still, the shower mostly got it out, but there was a bunch under my nails. And then I only have two magnets left. So if you wanted to have more that could go on here, maybe make a bunch and then pick the ones you like to put the magnets on because there's not like a ton of magnets left over for you to just stick every single one on here unless you have your own magnets. So that's something to think about. You could just make a lot, spend the whole day making a ton you like and then pick the ones that turn out the best or that you like the most and put them on here. So that's the clay succulents. Again, I thought it was still a good activity. I thought it was fun. And I didn't mind the mold ones because they were a lot easier. But the other ones, they look a lot better and more realistic, but they were just harder to do and it was frustrating for me. So just letting you know, cold, simple truth over here. And then yeah, the tools were helpful. I used the rolling pin a little bit right here. Sometimes this clay gets kind of sticky, so it would stick to the mat, so it wasn't always helpful. And then this to cut. This one, you can use this ballpoint to kind of stick the leaves together. And then this rubbery end, flimsy, I don't know, it kind of rubs out some of the texture in it, so it looks a little bit nicer. So those were all the things, and I was trying to think, I feel like I had something else that I wanted to say. I don't remember what it was. But anyways, I had I had a good time doing it. And it's still like, if you just want a project, you can sit down for a few nights in a row. Oh, I was going to tell you about baking them, which was very simple. You just take this. I just put it on a smaller cookie sheet and put it in my oven and baked it for the time they recommended and then let it cool. And then they were hard. And so I was just able to pop them out. And then the other ones, you cook them according to how tall, like your tallest plant is. So it's like 15 minutes per quarter inch or something like that. And so then I put them in and that worked out fine as well. I just put them on aluminum foil on one of my sheets because I didn't want the clay on a sheet that I use for food. So I put it on aluminum foil, but that worked really well. And so all in all, it was a good craft. It wasn't something that's my strong point or my favorite thing to do. So that's my struggle, not the Maker Crate struggle. So if you enjoy seeing these types of videos, please give me a thumbs up and I will see you next time.